Across this great nation, there is a culture of people who carry on a heritage. They have an intangible quality that can't be described, but it comes from deep within their hearts. They share an appreciation for the greatest things that come from Mother Earth. They watch over, understand, and care for the vast wilds of this great country. Fishing, hunting, and trapping are the foundations that Canada was built on. For over two centuries, we have taken to the woods and water to pursue wild game. Today, it's about conservation, preservation, and wildlife management. Whether you are a man or woman, fish or hunt, you should support sound wildlife management and proudly say, I am an angler and hunter. The Ontario Federation of Anglers and Hunters proudly presents Angler and Hunter Television. Brought to you by Canadian Tire, a proud partner of Angler and Hunter Television, Mercury Marine and Lund Boats, Yamaha ATVs, Winchester Ammunition, Browning Firearms, Suffolk Fishing Line, Rapala, Camillus Knives, Excalibur Crossbows, and Yukon Gear.
Have you ever sat back and thought about how many times a year you actually plan your schedule around eating? I mean, there's Thanksgiving, Christmas, Easter, birthdays, maple syrup festivals, corn roasts, rib fests, and the list goes on. It's obvious Canadians like to eat. For me, however, the most anticipated feast every year is frying up a mess of fresh spring crappies.
It's still young.
And as soon as the spring thaw hits and the shallows start to warm up, it's time to hit the lake and fill the boat with a pile of delicious black crappie.
Whoa! Whoa!
Now, it sure sounds easy when you think about it. Crappies are considered panfish after all, and they can often be found by the hundreds piled into warm, sheltered back bays. But the truth is, these little critters are temperature sensitive.
Sometimes it just takes the right lure, you know?
And can be the most finicky biters of any fish in the lake.
Got him. Oh, he got off. You see that?
The first step to finding where the fish might be is to study a map of the lake you intend to fish and locate areas that are likely to concentrate spawning crappies.
Okay, now just before I put this boat in the water, I'm going to quickly look at this tablet. We're going to go to the Scout Look fishing app. I'm going to just show you a few things on the lake. I want to double check a couple things. So there's basically Lake Scugog. Now down here in the southeast corner, all along that one shore, there's all sorts of cuts and canals back there. Now on the Hummingbird, you can't see those because it just shows you the lake transitions. And these are man-made canals, most of them. Like this one here, for instance, see how straight it is? It's definitely man-made, where this one looks just like a creek. But if you zoom in closer, you'll see these dark areas. It's actually deep water. Now I can probably get to about here with the Hummingbird and it won't show these man-made canals. But if you zoom in really close with the Scout Look app, you can see these canals are all flooded timber. Scout Look maps are real detailed. And obviously flooded timber can be pretty good. Beaver dams can be good. Beaver houses can be really good. So we're just gonna check the weather. GPS signal finds us here. Lake Scugog. Looks like a high of 16 today. I'm gonna check the hourly forecast and check the winds. Looks like it's gonna be a decent day, not much wind. So the Scout Look app also gives you precipitation by the hour, barometric pressure, humidity, any wind gusts that might happen, but also gives you a mosquito alert, lets you know if bugs are gonna be bad, but right here, peak game activity. So today is a fair day for fishing, it says. So it's 7:24 and 9:24 are the major times. The minors are 7:03 a.m. and 9:03 a.m. So this morning we might get lucky and get some fish early by the looks of things.
The Scout Look fishing app is a great way to locate spots and monitor the weather patterns letting you mark waypoints so that once you're on the water, it's a matter of turning on the Humminbird, cranking up the Merc, and running to all the spots you've marked.
We found the spot with some deep water and warmer water. Oh, slammed! Yeah! That's a good one! Oh, I went deep and I got him. Just a wee, easy. Gotta get down into the branches. Wow, they're eating that little tube. What's the water temperature? 55. See this cut? Warmer than the rest of the lake because it's so protected. And there's a beaver house there with crappies. Oh, he's nailed that thing. He's not quite a keeper. But I went by here and you could see there's a beaver house here. And with the water being so warm in here, there might be some bigger fish on this spot.
This portion of Angler and Hunter Television brought to you by Yamaha ATVs.
Look at this little guy go. Oh, that's a big one. Yeah, finally a slabber out of this spot. Woo. Now, see that? You want them bigger in your hand. Oh. I saw my float go down and let him take it. That's a keeper. All right, crappie setup is pretty simple. You got 6-pound monofilament. This is Suffolk Siege. And the first thing you're gonna wanna do is put a bobber stop on. Basically, it's a simple setup. You can buy these at Canadian Tire. You slide this little tube over your line and slide it up 10 or 15 inches. And you just slide the tube out, leaving the rope on your line. Get that tube off of there and pull both ends of this string. And that's on there. Trim these ends off. Right there. That'll stop your bobber from sliding up the line. Now you're gonna get a little bead out of the kit that comes with it. Not very good for guys with small fingers. And that goes on your line up to the bobber stop. And then my little styrofoam float. Now you see there's a rubber end at this end. That's the side the bead goes against. Feed your line through there. Bam. And now I've got a variety of little jig heads and tube jigs. I'm just gonna put a 16th ounce head on here, tie it on. Trim that little tag end. Now I've got a float. When it hits the water, it's gonna float up, hit the bobber stop, and my tube jig's down below. You can adjust that bobber stop if you want to just run shallow, or if you need deeper, you can run it up your line and it'll stop your float right there. And that's all you need. There's one. Oh, look at that. Wait, on the outside here. He was down in the dark. Well, that's not a bad one. Holy, he was in the middle of nowhere. I'm gonna turn around and go back. Nice clean looking fish though. That's just about the limit for eating size right there. You want them just a little bigger than your hand. Not bad. And I got giant hands. This is awesome. These fish are easy to catch. Come on. That's
That's a better one. Oh, it's a good one. Look at this fish. I'm gonna net him.
Get in the net. Oh.
Oh, he was hooked real good right through the snout. Now, I think this one's probably just a bit bigger in the hand. Well, close, but some girth, so there's some meat on that fish. I'm gonna keep this one. Oh, yeah. Nothing going up. Oh, maybe there's another one here. Nope. My float's going down. There's some sunfish in here, and for the most part, caught a couple decent ones, but there isn't the numbers there should be. And with the water temperature just hitting the low 50s, I'm thinking the bigger fish, the females, and the fish that are going to come in and spawn are still staging. And that means they'd be at the mouth. There's one. Look what I caught, a bass. Oh no, it's a chub. Big creek chub. That's a big one. Well, there you go, the crappies are all gone. Chub. That's musky bait. Oh, fumbled them. Anyway, there you go. Everything's moving in here. Big fish are all gone. I'm gonna head for the flats. See if I can find the staging fish.
This portion of Angler and Hunter Television brought to you by Winchester Ammunition.
So out here over these weed flats, the wind's died, it's gotten calm. I don't need that 9-foot rod anymore. The 9-foot rod's great for placing that float around brush piles and stuff like that from a distance. But out here, I'm making long casts, and I'm using braided line because I got such a long cast with a 6-pound Suffolk fluoro leader. But what I'm doing with this is a 6'9" medium light action R-type rod, and I can really work this bait. Now what I'll do is I'll let it sink down, but a lot of these fish, when I start swimming the float like this, they're looking at the float. He's hitting the float. And then they're coming up and hitting the bait. Just like that. See, he's just engulfing it. They're aggressive out here. This is the best crappie fishing I've had in some time. There's some right in front of me. They're everywhere. They're surrounding us. What am I gonna do? There's a good one right there. Oh, come on, giants. Where's the big fat ones? Got one. Not a big one though. Oh, he's not as good as I thought, but it's one. Oh, getting there. These are definitely the fish that are staging. What a day. Look at the bellies. The ones I was catching in the back, you recall, they were just skinny. Mostly males. These aren't males, these are fat ones. Oh, come on. Got one. Oh, nice. When they pull drag, you know they're a little better. Now they got soft, papery mouths, so you wanna have your drag loose. I'm netting this one, it looks like a big flopper. Wow, you could probably get away with topwater fishing some of these, but I'm doing pretty good this way right here. See that? As long as they're bigger than your hand, yeah, they're good to eat. Whew. It's one after the other here. It's only a matter of time, I think, until I catch into some of them big ones. And there's no sunfish out here. This is a school of crappie holding in a weed bed, staging before they head shallow. I just scored on this day. It's been a cold spring up until this week. Look at that right there. There's a pack of weeds with a few billion of them and one big one. Will the big one hit it? The big one spooked. Awesome. This weed patch, it's almost up to the surface here and it's just loaded. There's some big ones in this group. Oh no. This weed bed's loaded. Oh, they're getting fat. If I could put another decent fish in the boat, I got enough to do a fish fry, I think. Just one more. See the little chop here happening? That's one thing about the spring, is you always get that little north breeze once in a while that comes through and wrecks the visibility. Like, if I look over here, I really can't see anything. I can still see some over here. Once you lose the weed beds, I mean, you can cast and watch your float, but to sight fish for those big ones, you lose that ability. You might want to go shallow and find a couple cuts where you're protected from the wind.
Whoa, he's pulling drag, he's going crazy. Oh, oh, it's a fat one. Look at the size of this thing. I'm gonna net him. Oh, come on, don't get off. Got him.
A slabber. That ought to do it. Bigger my hand. Now it's the time to get my favorite part of crappie fishing out, my fillet knife. Whew. Okay, I got a live well full of crappies here. And the necessities when you're crappie fishing, a roll of paper towels, and
look at this.
Battery operated fillet knife. Anybody that likes filleting fish, these come in handy because filleting crappies wears out your wrist. So, like I said, crappies are good to eat. Kids love them. They're very white meat. An electric fillet knife, trust me. I'm going to do about 6 or 8 more here. But if you're going to do 20 or 30 crappies for a fish fry and you're using a regular fillet knife, man, your wrists get sore. Go out and get one of these, it's worth it. You can hack through these fish in no time at all, and I'm gonna leave the skin on these, throw them in a bag, and fry them up. Now that I have a decent bag of fish, it's time to put the Lund on the trailer and head home. I promised my daughter August that after school, we could chow down on some delicious crispy fried crappies.
The Fishing Edge is brought to you by Minn Kota and Humminbird.
To get the edge over the crappies, I utilize the map, side imaging, and temp gauge on my Humminbird 1199, which let me find the ideal temperatures outside the spawning areas and locate weed clumps where the bigger crappies were staging. The Minn Kota 80-pound thrust Altera allowed me to hold in shallow water where I could make subtle casts using a 9-foot Rapala float rod and a 6'9" R-type rod, matched with 1500 series Rapala Andros reels spooled with 15-pound Suffix 832 braid and a 6-pound Suffix fluorocarbon leader. Lucky Strike's portable telescopic mesh net made landing the crappies a cinch. And finally, a rechargeable Rapala cordless fillet knife made cleaning these fish a snap.
The weather for today's fishing was partially cloudy and 15 degrees. The barometer was falling and there was a light east wind out of the east, increasing to 20K in the afternoon.
Okay, I got all the skin off these fillets and I'm ready to throw them in the grease here. I got the oil heated up. The crappies are real small, so they fry fast. You don't have to leave them in this oil for long. So I'll probably just do 2 quick batches and we'll be eating. How are you making out over there? You okay there, Gus?
Is it ready yet?
Almost. The trick to making sure that you get a real crispy fish fry is like when you use fish crisp or any kind of this seasoning, make sure you pat the fish dry. You don't want it wet. So if you're filleting them fresh, make sure you pat them dry with some paper towels. Or if you've had it frozen, Make sure you pat it dry with paper towels once it's thawed. If it's wet, the batter won't stick properly. Okay, here we go.
It's real crispy.
Oh, you've already got your plate loaded.
You don't have anything.
I'm gonna have buttered beans, some potatoes, and lots of this crispy crappies. This is cool. You can eat this piece. Take it. Yummy?
Yes.
That's about as easy as it gets right there.
It's still yummy.
It is, yeah. A quick day on the lake. Fillet a few crappies. Home in time for dinner. Even the dog's excited. Do you like fish? He's hungry. Fish dog. It's good, eh? Nothing like a fish fry. It's my favorite fish to eat. Cheers, Gus.
Closed captioning of Angler and Hunter Television is brought to you in part by Ontario Out of Doors Magazine. Angler and Hunter Television has been brought to you by Canadian Tire, Mercury Marine and Lund Boats, Yamaha ATVs, Winchester Ammunition, Browning Firearms, Suffolk Fishing Line, Rapala, Camillus Knives, Excalibur Crossbows, and Yukon Gear. For more information on the products used in this episode of Angler and Hunter Television, visit ahtv.com. Be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Remember, conserve and protect our great outdoors.